Hello friend, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. This is narrator Ravi Gupta. Today we are going to talk about freshwater generator. This is the most important topic which has been asked in MEO class 4 and also in MEO class 2 written exam. So please remain tuned till last. I will explain each and everything about freshwater generator. In today's topic, we will start with the material used in the freshwater generator. After that, through different diagram such as alpha level diagram, and Sasakura manufacturer diagram, I will explain how this type of freshwater generator works and what are the different alarms and safeties which are provided in the freshwater generator, and also what chemical treatment we need to do for freshwater generator. So let's start the video with the material. So the freshwater generator material which is used basically consists of four things. First thing is the cell. The cell is made up of fabricated steel with sheet rubber coating. Okay, so basically idea is to use a cell which is of non-ferrous metal. Why? Because as you know, we are using seawater for as a component for generating the fresh water. Therefore, the component should be non-ferrous. Otherwise, if it is ferrous metal, it will cause corrosion and have a corrosion problem. So for that reason, we are using fabricated steel or non-ferrous metal such as copper nickel with rubber coating. Okay, the coating is provided. This is the cell. Okay, this is a cell. The cell is made up of fabricated steel with a coating of rubber so that to avoid any chances of corrosion. After that, the tubes which are used for the heat exchange purpose are made up of aluminium brass. Okay, after that, the condenser plate. Okay, the condenser plate which is used is made up of titanium. In some cases, both the tubes of the condenser plate as well as the evaporator plate are made up of titanium, and the emitters are made up of knitted monel metal. Okay, now the first question comes to our mind and which is generally asked in exam is that on which principle did the freshwater generator work? So the freshwater generator works on a very simple principle that when the pressure decreases, the boiling point temperature of the liquid also decreases, and if the pressure increases, the boiling point temperature also increases. So using that principle we have designed freshwater generator which can give us the fresh water by extracting from the seawater. So what we are doing in freshwater chamber, this is the freshwater chamber, we are creating a low pressure zone or almost a vacuum zone where the By creating the vacuum zone, we are decreasing the boiling point of a temperature of a water to such a point that by using a simple heat exchange, we can extract fresh water. So let's see how it works. So before starting the working, let me tell you what are the components first. This is the cell of the freshwater generator. Okay, this is the condenser part, this is the evaporator part. Okay, and these are the ejector, brine ejector and air ejector, and this is the ejector pump, or you can say seawater pump. And the fresh water which is produced is extracted by distillate pump and it is monitored by selenometer. I will explain each and every component while explaining the working. So let's start. With the help of the ejector, a vacuum condition is established inside the freshwater generator. So what is happening that with the help of this brine ejector and air ejector, we are creating a vacuum condition inside this cell chamber. Okay, now seawater is supplied through pump which has been boiled up to vapor form by utilizing the heat of a jacket cooling water outlet. So what we are doing now, you must see carefully that the seawater is taking suction from the seawater pump and it has been passed through a restricted orifice to evaporator. Now in this evaporator zone, the seawater is passing and exchanging heat with the jacket water. This jacket water is coming from the outlet of the engine temperature, having a temperature around 75 to 80 degrees Celsius. So this temperature is sufficient for boiling of the water as the condition inside the cell is maintained in a vacuum condition. So as we have told you that when the pressure decreases, the boiling point also temperature also decreases. So therefore, the boiling point of the seawater has been decreased to such temperature that it boils off at temperature around 45 to 60 degree. So for that reason, the temperature of jacket water 75 to 80 is sufficient enough to boil the seawater. So during the heat exchange process in the evaporator, the seawater exchange the heat with the jacket water and convert into a vapor form of fresh distillate water. That fresh distillate water now pass in a vapor form through a demister. Okay, what is a demister? Demisters is basically a type of a net which is made up of knitted molten metal. Why it is provided? Let's see. Now, this heat exchange process takes place in the lower part of a pressure cell of a heat exchanger. As I have told you, the boiled up vapor is passed through a demister. Okay, which filter any salt filled water droplet and then it pass through the upper condenser. Okay, so the basic purpose of demister is to filter any salt laden vapor which has occurred because of sudden rapid evaporation. The salt laden vapor is being extracted by demister and fall back to the evaporator zone, and the other vapors component are passed to the condenser, and therefore demister is provided. If anyone asks you why demister is provided, you should say that. Now, after that, it is passed to the upper condenser where the vapor is cooled down to distillate water by utilizing seawater as cooling medium. So one thing you need to take care is that now the heat exchange of the seawater with the jacket water have taken place and it has converted the seawater, some amount of seawater, into vapor form. That vapor form is passing through demister and any salt component is been extracted back by the demister, and that is further is led to condenser. Now the condenser, second heat exchange process taking place. This heat exchange is taking place between the vapor of the seawater, which is a distillate water, distilled vapor with seawater. That seawater is also coming from this seawater pump. A line is passed through this and it is also providing the cooling for the condenser. So as the vapor enter and it is cooled by the seawater, because vapor temperature is around 60 to 80 degree, now this has been cooled by seawater having temperature of 25 to 35 degrees Celsius maximum. So this cooling will cause the vapor to get converted into a distillate water, which will be collected in a tray. This is the tray. A tray is provided just beneath the condenser where the vapor which is cooled down will be collected. Now this collected water will now be taken out with the help of a distillate pump. The distillate pump will take out this condensed water, but this distillate water is finally collected in a container which is connected with a distillate pump and pumped to the freshwater tank. In order to maintain vacuum condition, brine and air ejector continuously remove the brine and air. Okay, we will come to this part later on. First, one more thing I want to tell you is that now the second question come to our mind. Okay, the seawater pump is supplying continuous seawater to the cell chamber. So in order to maintain the vacuum condition, the air and the excess brine is need to be extracted continuously. For that reason, two ejectors, one brine and air ejector, are provided, which is extracting the excess water. Brine is removing the excess seawater and air excess is been removed by the air ejector to the overboard, so that the vacuum condition is maintained and properly the seawater is also maintained at a correct level. For that reason, brine and air jet is also provided. Now, the second thing I want to tell you that as the water is getting collected and it is passed through a distillate pump, now that is being sent to a freshwater tank by monitoring through a salinometer. So what is salinometer? We will come to here. Now, what are the alarms which are provided in a freshwater generator? to ensure that the distillate water which is produced is of good quality, an alarm of high salinity is provided, which will be initiated when the distillate water salinity exceeded 4 ppm. So this is a question asked that what is the maximum ppm of salinity which can be allowed in a freshwater generator is that 4 ppm. Okay, but in our shipping industry, we keep the limit much below that. 1 ppm in normal case we are maintaining so that we get much good quality of water. Now, salinity alarm consists of three-way valve which will divert the flow back to the pressure cell if salinity increases. This is done by operating the solenoid which is attached to with the salinity indicator and alarm. So let me come to the diagram. I will tell you now what is happening. Now, as I have told you, the demister is filtering the soil dead and vapor, but sometime it may happen that some of the vapor may get passed through and it may also increase the salinity. Also, sometime what happen if there is a small leakage in the seawater tubes, then that may also get contaminated. For that reason, we need to continuously monitor the collected distillate water. For that reason, the salinometer is provided. Okay, the salinometer function is basically what happened. It take a tapping from the water which has been passed through the distillate pump and it monitor the salinity. Check salinity. If the salinity is exceeded 4 ppm, it will do? It will divert the flow to back to the pressure cell. In some cases, most of the cases, it divert the flow to the back to the pressure cell chamber, and in some cases it divert the flow to the bilges. But this is now obsolete. Most of the time now we are diverting the flow to the pressure cell. If it is okay, if the salinity is within the limit, then what it will do, it will allow the flow to the freshwater tank. So basically it's a three-way valve which is diverting the flow depending upon the salinity of the water. So it is an additional check and safety which is provided in a freshwater generator to ensure the quality of the distillate water is very good quality, because this distillate water is going to be used everywhere in the for LTHT system, for boiler water and everything. So it has to be of good quality. Now, as you can see, this is the diagram of alpha level front portion. You can see this is the brine outlet and this is the ejector feed inlet. Okay, this is the heating medium in and out, and this is the cooling medium, condenser cooling medium in and out. Okay, and this is a distillate pump out. Now, second thing question asks, okay, what are the alarm is provided? Now we know that salinity alarm is provided. Now the second question is asked, what are safety provided in freshwater generator? So a pressure relief valve is provided to relieve excess pressure inside the chamber which may arise if some of the condenser tube leaks. So what happened? Basically, as you can see in this diagram, if the condenser tube leak, what will happen? It will fill up this whole chamber. Means if there is major leakage, though the brine ejector is removing the excess seawater, but still if the leakage is major, it may happen the whole chamber may get filled. So it may build up the excess pressure. To prevent the building of excess pressure, a relief valve is provided. It's not shown here right now. A relief valve is provided on the top of this pressure chamber so that to ensure in any case of this happening, it will release the excess pressure. That is the safety provided in a freshwater generator. Now, the third question is that what chemical treatment we need to do and why do we need a chemical treatment? Basically, what happened when the seawater vapor is formed, at that time CO2 is liberated from calcium bicarbonate. So basically, from where the calcium bicarbonate comes, as we know that seawater contains salt particles such as sodium chloride, calcium bicarbonate, all that. So one of the component is the calcium bicarbonate. When the seawater is changes into vapor form, at that time the CO2 is liberated and it form a calcium carbonate. That calcium carbonate have a tendency of forming a soft scale. To prevent this soft scale accumulation, we are doing a chemical dosing. So what we are doing, a chemical dosing in the seawater line. So mainly what happened, a tank is provided and tapping to this seawater line, what we do, we dose a small doses of amount of chemical so that the calcium carbonate which is formed, it doesn't get adhered to the tube surface and it been taken out through a brine ejector. For that reason, we are doing the chemical treatment to prevent the adhesion of the calcium carbonate component onto the tube plates. For that reason, we are doing the chemical treatment. For example, we are using one of the companies, such as there are many companies, Uniter, Drew Marine. In Drew Marine, we are using an amorol based component which is used for freshwater dosing. Basically, what we do, depending upon the production capacity, the dosing rate varies. Okay, and the dosing, and we dose the chemical in the dosing tank mixed with the freshwater. Okay, now this is another pick. Now you can see here, this is the diagram of a Sasakura. Means the Sasakura manufacturer uses this component. What they are using to seawater pump, the seawater is fed to a tube, vertical tubes. And why the vertical tubes are provided? Because it ensures that the vapor which is formed doesn't get any restriction passes and it get directly to the up part. Now the jacket cooling is provided and the seawater is provided from here. A heat exchange will take place between the jacket water and seawater, and vapor will be formed. That vapor will be filtered by this gemistry plate, and after that it is been passed to a condenser. This same seawater component is again used for cooling the condenser, and it is collected in a tray. This tray is taking out the fresh water, and the brine ejector and the air ejector is provided, which will remove the excess brine and the air to ensure the vacuum condition and correct water level is maintained inside a chamber. So it's very simple. Okay, I hope you now it's clear. This is another image which I have taken from MacGeorge. Now as you can see, very simple diagram. Basically, you need to make your mind that basically in freshwater generator there are two chamber. One is the condenser chamber, one is the evaporator chamber. In evaporator chamber, the exchange of heat take place which convert the seawater into vapor form, and in condenser chamber, that vapor which been converted is converted to a distillate water form. Both of the heat exchange is taking place. In lower chamber, the heat exchange is taking place between the jacket water and the seawater, and in upper chamber, the exchange of heat is taking place from the distillate vapor and seawater. Okay, and that water which is been condensed is collected beneath the tray provided in a condenser, and that is been taken out by a distillate pump. So it's very simple. I hope I have made clear how a freshwater generator work. If you have still have any doubt, please do comment below. I will reply back. And if you like this video, if you think I have given you some valuable information, please hit the like button and please subscribe. Please subscribe, because Marine Engineering Hub aim is to bring all our marine personnel to this platform so that we can learn and grow. Image credit goes to this Volume 8 and MacGeorge. Thank you, friend. Have a good day.